Hello and welcome to PDFsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a DVT 550 camera. I have here a Cognex DVT 550 vision sensor. A couple things you'll notice, I already have a lens that I've put on it and I have it plugged in. This cable is going to an Ethernet switch through our Ethernet network and the computer that works with the software. And this is the power supply of 24 volts, which is coming from the DVT isolated breakout board, or isolated bob. It's being powered by a power supply that was supplied by DVT with this breakout board. 24 volts again. And the SmartImage sensor cable or lead that's going to the camera is a DVT CBL-10. The dash 10 just means that my cable is 10 feet long. That's all that means. You may have a dash 25. It just means that it's the same exact cable for you and you'll be able to follow this test. It just means that the cable is longer. It's 25 feet. Depending on the application of where this breakout board is in relation to your camera. So now that that's hooked up and it's powered up, I go by the status light that should be green or blinking green on the camera itself. Of course, if it's red or blinking red, that's usually indicates there's a problem, but it looks like we're going to be okay. Now, a couple things about the DVT 550 before I get started. Some specifications. Its resolution is 640 by 480. That's 640 over 480. And that's typically with most of the DVT cameras in that range. The frames per second, which is considered the acquisition rate of the camera, and this is actually pretty high. It's 75 frames per second. And the storage capability, that's the firmware job storage memory capacity, is 16 megabytes. All right. So those are just a few things. There's a lot more specifications. If you need to know more, please call us at PDF Electric and Supply. So in order to test this, we like to do a few things, a few areas of test. As I just showed you the Ethernet cable, if you're looking on the screen, and I'm going to move my arrow around here a little bit, the DVT 550 in the Network Explorer, which this tells us what cameras are on the network, and in particular it's the DVT 550 we're testing. I'm going over it right now, and it's kind of in this grayed out area, and it has some of these specifications where the status is up right now, meaning that it recognizes the cameras there, and IP address. So the IP address automatically establishes itself as long as the Ethernet is connected properly through the computer and your network, and that the Ethernet card within the camera is working properly. The reason that's important, and the reason that the status being up is important, means that, you know, all my Ethernet connections are correct as I can clearly see in front of me, but it also means that the Ethernet card inside the camera is working. So if the Ethernet card inside the camera wasn't working, we wouldn't be able to have this IP address and our status would not be up. It just wouldn't see a camera at all, really. And that's a dead giveaway that tells you that your Ethernet card is bad. All right. So there's one thing that's out of the way as part of the test. Second thing is, if you look over to the left under the camera properties, it gives some description about what's going on with the camera, what the IP address is, the type of camera it is, the name. And underneath features, it tells us that the application it's running is Intellect 1.5.1, which is the software that we normally use for a test because it's pretty complete, it's very new, and it helps us to test the inputs, the outputs, the IP address. Everything's very clear and upfront. So, now that it has the same Intellect version build as the software that I'm using, I'm going to right click in this gray area and select connect. We're going to connect up to the computer, camera. The first thing that we're going to see is whether there's an image or not. Okay, so I may not be using the best lens for this particular application. I usually carry a couple lenses. I'm going to fit this with a 100 millimeter lens. Sometimes that helps. But one of the things that I wanted to point out about the lens is the aperture of the lens, and something that you need to be concerned with, because if you don't immediately get a picture or an image or even any light on the screen, doesn't necessarily mean that the camera's not working. You may want to check to see if the aperture is open. And you could do that by looking through one end of the lens. I'll try to focus on something here. You can see through the lens, through the camera, onto this green that I'm pointing at here. That means that the aperture is open. And if you look on the side of most lenses, there's an open and closed for the aperture. And what that's doing is it's opening and closing the amount of light that can come through this lens. So, as the second part of the test, which is to make sure my lens is photosensitive, that I'm able to get some sort of a picture, even if I can't quite adjust this perfectly, I at least need to see that there's light coming through, that the sensor is capable of detecting light, and then using the correct lens, you can actually zoom in and make some more sense out of the picture. I'm having a little bit of trouble with it for this particular video, but I think you get the idea. All right. And it also depends. Some cameras are better zoomed way out and looking at things that are further away, and some cameras are focused on things that are very, very close. Okay. It depends again on your application. So I know that the lens is working. I'm able to pick up light in some shapes through it. And I've said in previous videos, the lenses are pretty much either they're working or they're not working. With the exception that if you get some sort of debris on the lens, then you may want to look at that and make sure it's clear and that you don't need to clean it off. But in this particular case, it looks pretty good. What I'm going to do is I'm going to reduce this video image. I'm going to minimize that. And we're going to move on to the second part of the test, which is our inputs and outputs. All right. I'm opening up System in the top menu bar, and I'm going to go down to Digital I/O. And then when the window pops open, it's going to give you three choices: DVT, Ethernet I/O, Physical I/O, Virtual I/O. You want to check Physical I/O. I'm going to double click that. And I'm going to open up this big. And it's showing my inputs and outputs, or pin 1 through 8. And it's currently showing a value of 0. So the first thing I want to test is the outputs. I'm going to go ahead and click File, and I have a preset. If you guys decide to send in your camera that you may think that there's a problem with, I have a preset program that tests all the outputs at once. And what we're looking for is we're looking for those zeros, all of those zeros in unison, to turn to a one. If, for instance, and we're going to see if it changes here right now, and they all change to a one. For instance, one of the outputs does not change to a one, it remains as a zero. Then we know there's a problem with an output. Although these are pretty solid, this is another thing that it's either working or it's not working. And in this particular case, it's working, so we're satisfied with that. Now we're going to check the inputs. Okay. DVT test inputs. This is going to require a little bit of work from me. I'm going to need to use a probe, which I'll show you in just a second here. I have a probe that I'm going to use. One end is a raw soldered wire. The other end is the probe. What I'm trying to do here is two things. I want to make sure that when I give it a 24 volts positive, which is, if you look at the screen printing here, right underneath the 24V, underneath this LED, it's a white wire. I'm going to hold that white wire. I'm going to get my 24 volts positive there, and I'm going to basically do what's considered a controlled short. And we're going to do input 1, 2, 3. Now, meanwhile, I'm watching also on the software. You can't just go by the LEDs. You need to make sure that the software is agreeing that this is changing from a 0 to a 1. If it's not, then there's a problem. But so far, all of these zeros are changing to a 1, and we look good. We're in good shape here. All right, so the Ethernet works, the lens works, the inputs and the outputs work perfectly. The other thing that we usually test is when I first got this camera in, I had to flash it to the DVT 1.5.1 software that you see me using now. And it was using a previous software, either Framework or DVT, but usually an older version. Now, the reason that is important and I use it as part of my test is because I want to make sure that I can erase the flash memory and be able to load a new software onto this camera with no problem. That lets me know that its ability to store a program is still open, viable, and working. Okay, so it's very important. It's the only way I can really test it is without actually cluttering a camera with something is to do it that way. So again, I recommend the Intellect 1.5.1. It's very easy software to use. It's very complete, and it pretty much tests every possible aspect of the computer, of the camera. Excuse me. So if you think that you're having a problem with the camera, you'd like to send us it to test it, or if you're interested in possibly an exchange program with a camera that isn't working for you, those are all things that you can call us and talk to us about that we offer here. Please see us at PDF Electric and Supply Company, pdfsupply.com. Thank you.